So in this part of the video, I'm going to tell you how to find the valency factor for a redox reaction. So before going ahead, let me tell you, I have written 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 examples you can see. All these 7 are of different types. So make sure these are the all possible types of questions which can come in this segment. And each one is having a better level than the previous one. So starting from the easiest to the toughest, we are going to go one by one. So make sure that you hold tight till the last, you see the proper video and understand how to find the valency factor in each case. So here, what is a valency factor for redox reaction? For redox reaction, valency factor is electron transferred per species. Understand, it's not per atom, it is per species. Sometimes it can, the species can be atom also. Single atom species, single atomic species is always possible. But it is for the whole molecule. Keep this thing in mind, or the whole ion. So in simple words, I'm saying electron transferred per species. That means I don't care how many electron carbon atom has transferred. I care how many electron this whole oxalate will transfer. I don't care how many electron this iron has transferred. I care about how many electrons this whole FeC2O4 will transfer. So understand, electron transferred per species we have to find. So let's start. As simple as that. Manganese has an oxidation state of plus 7. Plus 7 to plus 2, the change you can find is of 5. And no other oxidation state change is going on. So the valency factor comes out as 5. Because 5 electron transferred for 1 MnO4 minus. So electron transfer per MnO4 minus is 5. And that's your valency factor. Easiest. C2O4 2 minus 2 CO2. Here, if you'll find the oxidation state by taking in X, what you will get? You will get plus 3 here, you will get plus 4 here. Now, plus 4 to plus 3, what is the change in the oxidation state? 1, 3 to 4. Now, this change in the oxidation state is for 1 carbon. So, for 2 carbon, the total change comes out to be as 2. So, 3 to 4, electron transferred 1. And for 2 carbon, electron transferred 2. So here for total oxalate, the electron transferred are 2. So the valency factor comes out to be 2. Whose valency factor is this? It's better always to write that it's the valency factor of C2O4 2-. So the valency factor of C2O4 2- comes out to be as 2. In case your doubt comes, sir, if I take, instead of this species, if I take this species, then sir, this has only 1 carbon. Na? Then why do you multiply with 2? Simple, yeah. If you take this species, you will get his valency factor. If you take that species, you will get his valency factor. So depends upon the question what they ask you. For example, if I ask you, find the valency factor of CO2. Simple, plus 4 to plus 3, change of 1. There is just 1 carbon, valency factor 1. But here I am asking for C2O4 2-. So from plus 3 to plus 4, change of 1 for 1 carbon, and for total 2 carbon, change of 2. So change of 2 for per species is the answer. So this is level 1, level 2. So understand, I hope you understood the meaning of per species. It's not always atom. Sometimes one atom can give us the answer. Sometimes the species can have more than one atom undergoing the change. Third one. Now it's a very good example to start with. Now we are jumping from level 1 to directly level 3. Now this was, I think, level 1, both of them. Now here what happens, same MnO4 minus, that is Mn in plus 7, same person becomes plus 2 also, plus 6 also. So when one person has two different oxidation states on the right side, make sure that you write both changes separately. What does it mean? Plus 7 to plus 2, how much change happened? There is a change of 5 in the oxidation state. And when there are two different changes going on, it's always smart to write increase and decrease along with it. You will understand the use of it, but make a habit. When one species becomes two species, make sure to write the increase and decrease in the oxidation state along with the change. So plus 7 to plus 2, there is a change of 5. And plus 7 to plus 2, that means there is a decrease in the oxidation state. From plus 7 to plus 6, there is a change of 1. Plus 7 to plus 6, there is a change of 1. And 7 to 6, there is a decrease going on. Is our job done? No, we have to find the total electron transfer. But first, we understand one thing. For us, luckily, at this level, both are degrees. Both are degrees means what? The electron transfers in the same direction for both of them. That means from plus 7 to plus 2 also, electron is taken. And from plus 7 to plus 6 also, electron is taken. Now, it does not matter taken or given. What matters is, both way oxidation state is decreasing. But, did we find the total electron transferred yet? No. Why? We were 3MnO4 minus. And you have found just for one. Let's see. Out of 3 MnO4 minus, how many are becoming Mn2 plus? 2. So, yeah, from plus 7 to plus 2, there is a change of 5. Then for 2, there is a change of 10. So, you can write it here. From plus 7 to plus 2, there is a change of 5. And for 2 manganese, there is a change of 10. But sir, in MnO4 minus, there is 1 manganese only. Correct. But 2 MnO4 minus went to Mn2 plus. Na, yeah. Check the valency. 2. Out of 3, 2 came here. So, yeah, total electron transfer I am asking. Total electron transfer. So, MnO4 minus plus 7 to plus 2, change of 5 for 1 manganese. There are 2 such people coming. So, 5 into 2, 10 decrease is going on. MnO4 minus 2, Mn plus 6, decrease of 1. How many manganese came here? 1. So, in total, there is a decrease of 1 here. So, what happened? Out of 3 MnO4 minus, 2 went to plus 2 and 1 went to plus 1. I found the total electron transferred as 11. So, if the total electron transfer is 11, the valency factor will be not 11. Why? Let's see. Electron transfer is 11. So, the valency factor is not electron transfer. The valency factor is electron transfer per species. That means in this whole process, in this half reaction, MnO4 minus 3 of them transferred 11 electron. So, here 11 by 3 electron transferred per MnO4 minus, and that's your valency factor. You get the idea? Electron transfer were 11. For how many MnO4 minus? For 3 of them. So we simply did, if 11 electrons are transferred by 3 people, then bhaiya, how many electrons are transferred by 1 person? So we can simply say it is 11 by 3. And that's your valency factor. So I hope this one you understood. Make sure that you practice it one more time by yourself. MnO4 minus to Mn2 plus Mn plus 6. We found total electron transfer. Understand in this way. Beyond this point, the question will become tough if you think more about chemistry. Stop thinking about chemistry now. Think in your day-to-day life. Let's say you had two businesses. Clear? What you did? You did two businesses and in both you had loss. In one case, you had a loss of 10 rupees. In second case, you get a loss of 1 rupees. So total, how much is your loss? 11. Is that clear? So that's a total electron transfer. Then, how many per species? How many species were there? 3 in total. So, bhaiya, 11 loss for 3. That means 11 by 3 is the loss for 1. So, valency factor is always for 1 species. Valency factor is always the electron transfer per species. Let's come in this part. In this case, what is happening? K2CR2O7 plus 14HCl gives you 2KCl plus CrCl3 plus 3Cl2. Let's think we have to find the valency factor of HCl. Let's say that's the question. Simple. Understand, HCl is becoming, or Cl is becoming, here also Cl, here also Cl, here also Cl. So let's write it separately. So, bhaiya, 14Cl minus I have on the left side. 14, check. On the right side, 2Cl minus are coming from KCl. 3 into 2, 6Cl minus are coming from CrCl3. I hope it's clear to us. And total 3 into 2, 6Cl0 is coming from Cl2. That means out of 14Cl minus, like here, out of 3, 2 went here, 1 went here. Here what happened? Out of 14Cl minus, 2 went in KCl, 6 went in CrCl3, and 6 went in Cl2. Let's see one by one. So, look here, Cl minus 1 to minus 1, no change. Cl minus 1 to minus 1, no change. So, basically these two, this 6 plus 2, 8 Cl minus, previous lecture, EAC, spectator ion, redox ion. So out of 14 Cl minus, this 8 Cl minus are the spectator ion. So ignore them. Next, Cl from minus 1 to 0, change of 1. Out of 14, how many came here? 6. So change of 1 into 6, total 6. So how many electron transfer? 6. So valency factor will be electron transferred by total species. How much electron transferred? 6. Total species, how much? 14. So by here 3 by 7 is the valency factor of HCl. See this question very well. So after this, if this was a little bit doubtful case, after this the clarity will come. As you go more and more forward, better and better clarity will come in this kind of questions. So what happened here? Out of 14 HCl we understood, out of 14 Cl minus, this 2 plus 6, total 8 Cl minus are unchanged. Ignore. And 6 Cl minus, from minus 1 to came, it came to 0. So change of 1. So for 6, change of 6. So there is a total electron transfer of 6. And how many species were there? Total species were 14. How do you know?
3 by 14.
So 6 by 14, 3 by 7. In the same way, here we found total electron transfer 11. Species 3, so 11 by 3. Let's go ahead. Now the next very important question is FeC2O4. FeC2O4 becomes Fe3 plus N2CO2. So here what is happening? It's a very important question. People do it wrong for valency factor a lot. It's a very important question to be done correct. Huge blunder it is. So here Fe is in plus 2. And carbon is in plus 3. Like C2O4 to minus, carbon plus 3. Here, see, understand what is happening. Here, till now what was happening was Mn underwent the change, carbon undergone the change, Mn undergone the change in different ways, but only Mn undergone the change. Here only Cl minus undergone the change. For example number 5, two different people are undergoing change. Check. Fe plus 2 to plus 3. And carbon went from plus 3 to plus 4. So I hope this is very clear to us that Fe is also undergoing the change, carbon is also undergoing the change. So now think in this way that you are running a business with your partner. You are iron and your business partner is carbon. Let us see overall how many electrons you transfer. As simple as that. Electron means money, let us say. How much money you transfer. If you go from plus 2 to plus 3, plus 2 to plus 3, there is a change of 1, and 2 to 3, there is an increase. Always remember, when there is more than one change happening, you should always write increase and decrease for removing all the kinds of doubts in the later phase. So plus 2 to plus 3, 1, increase. Plus 3 to plus 4, plus 3 to plus 4, change of 1. But there are 2 carbons here, so change of total 2 and happily increase. So here 2 to 3 increase, 3 to 4 increase. So basically your business partner gave 2 rupees increase, you gave 1 rupees increase. So as total FeC2O4 gave how much increase? Total increase 3. So the valency factor comes out to be 3 by 1. That is 3. I hope this part is clear to us. What happened here? Plus 2 to plus 3, there is an increase of 1. Plus 3 to plus 4, there is an increase of 1 again. But for 2 carbon, there is an increase of 2. So overall, FeC2O4, ferrous oxalate, FeC2O4, total had an increase of 1 plus 2, 3. So the valency factor of this whole molecule is 3. That is electron transferred per FeC2O4. So Fe transferred, 2. Someone asks you, nahin, tell me the valency factor of only Fe. 1. Tell me the valency factor of only oxalate. 2. We found here also. Together for FeC2O4 as a species, what's the valency factor? 3. 1 increase here, 2 increase here. So I think this part is very clear to us. Next, I am going to go for the last two examples which are very important. And very nice, beautiful examples they are. So let's undergo with NH4 whole twice Cr2O7, giving you N2N Cr2O3. Let us see. Here nitrogen is in -3. We can write it here in a nice, neat and clean manner. Even though this has become a khichdi here, but theek hai. My mood is very small. Thanks to the lockdown. All of a sudden we have to make the videos. So little bit adjustment you will have to do. I know the voice will also not be very clear to us. But I am not having any Bluetooth media to share the audio file right now. But sooner or later we'll get through it. But anyway, let's see this example. NH4 whole twice Cr2O7. What is it giving us? It is giving us nitrogen. It's also giving us Cr2O3. And let us take in this example. Let us take in this example. So let us see in this example that what is the valency factor of NH4 whole twice Cr2O7. So let's start. So here nitrogen is in -3, chromium is in +6. It's a simple like ammonium ion is there and dichromate is there. Here 0, here +3. So let us see what happened. Again, remember Cr is also undergoing the change, nitrogen is also undergoing the change. So whenever you write any change, make sure to mention increase and decrease. So -3 to 0, there is a change of 3. There are how many nitrogen? 2. So overall change 6. Increase or decrease here? -3 to 0. If you are having -3 rupees and you have 0 now, that means your marks got increased. Imagine you got -3 marks in one of the tests. The next test you got 0. So there is an increment of marks. Similarly, +6 to +3. How much is the change? Change of 3. How many chromium are there? 2. So here change total is 6. Understood? +6 to +3, change of 3. For 2 chromium, change of 6. So there is a decrease of 6. So here now, 6 increase, 6 decrease, what to do here? Now what most of the people do is that they subtract this. No. Understand what is one very simple logic. If I give you 20 rupees. If I give you 20 rupees and you took 20 rupees. So how much is the transaction? I give you 20 rupees and you took 20 rupees. So what will be the transaction? So if you think the answer is 0, it's very stupid here. If you say the answer is 40, sir, you gave 20, I took 20, so total 40. No, why, sir? The transaction happened of only 20 rupees. Get it? Should I show you one note of 20? If I have one 20 rupees note, I give it to you. I gave 20, you took 20. What got transferred? Only 20. So what do we mean? In such a case, you can see, in this case, 6 increase, 6 decrease. That means, one of them, let's say 6 increase, let us say, this person released 6 electron. This part gained 6 electron. So 6 electron given, 6 electron taken, overall change 6. So when both increase, add. When both decrease, add. When one increase, one decrease, find either complete increase or find complete decrease. So bhaiya, how much is the electron transferred? Electron transferred is 6. Why 6? Because 6 increase, 6 decrease, they are equal. So bhaiya, what do we say? Total transfer is 6 only, but is this for one species? Yes, ammonium dichromate is one species only, so 6 by 1, so valency factor is 6. This part of the question is, I think, clear. And the final last part and the hot favorite question for NEET exam is disproportionation reaction. In this reaction, we have to find the valency factor of bromine. Now here, why it is written at the last, why it is the toughest one? Because here, by God's grace and by my choice of the example, the electron was balanced already. Here it was 6 up, here it was 6 down, already balanced. But not always the God or the paper setter is going to be so much graceful for you or so much concerned for you. They will like to give this kind of a question where the electrons are automatically balanced. They can give you this kind of question also where the electrons are not balanced at all. What to do? For disproportionation reactions, why? Step number one, balance. For finding the valency factor, step number one is balance the reaction. Step number two is that find either change. And if you are wondering why either change, I think after this example number 6, you might have understood why either change. Because in disproportionation reaction, one person get oxidized, other get reduced. So one gave electron, other took the electron. So you have to just find either one of them. You can either find how much rupees you bought, or you can find how much rupees I lost. Because whatever I lost, you gained. So in simple words, balance and find either change. So do we have to balance the whole reaction? No. What to do? Just do the first step of the EAC method. What is the first step of the EAC method? Electron balance. How to do that? First thing, it's a disproportionation reaction. Same example I took in the previous video, in which we balanced bromine, this reaction, through a disproportionation reaction. What to do? Just write bromine 2 times. After writing bromine 2 times, making marry to BrO3-, make the other bromine marry to Br-. And remember, marriage has to be successfully completed till the end of the balancing. What does it mean? From 0 to plus 5, change of 5. And for 2 people, change of 10. From 0 to minus 1, change of 1. For 2 people, change of 2. Now it can be cancelled out. So I will write here 1, I will write here 5. And we'll cross multiply here and here. So 5 here, 1 here. So I'm not wasting my time in balancing part here, because for that a separate whole video is there. So if you are feeling problem, this is you went very fast, what to do? Stop the video. Open the other one. Check the balancing. At the last I balanced this same reaction only. So it will be very easy for us to understand there. Here let's focus upon finding balancing factor. Now electron balance na. We have to balance atoms now, charge now. Don't worry about it. Don't balance anything now. This is what the balancing we require. So dekho yaar. Now 5Br2 is becoming Br-. So 0 to minus 1, what is the change? 1. And for 10, there is a total change of 10. What 10? Increase or decrease? 0 to minus 1, decrease. So balancing I have done, and now I am finding the either change. So I will find both the change, and I will show you that both changes are same. Both the changing will be same, just like that question. But there it was auto balanced. We didn't have to do this thing like we are doing the balancing here. But sometimes you will have to balance also, especially for disproportionation. So from 0 to plus 5, from 0 to plus 5, there is a change of 5. And for 2 bromine, there is a change of 10. So 0 to plus 5, increase. So you can see here, this segment, 10 increase. And this pair, 10 decrease. So 10 decrease, 10 increase. How much is the electron transfer? Don't say 20, please. 10 only. If I gave you 10 rupees, you took 10 rupees. Overall transaction, 10 rupees. So electron transferred, 10. So valency factor will be electron transferred by total species. How many electron transferred? 10. How many total species? 5 plus 1. Total 6 bromine are there. So the answer is 5/3 is the valency factor. If someone asks you what is the equivalent weight of bromine in this reaction, simple. Molar mass of bromine by 5/3, that is 3 into approximately 160/5. Bromine I can take approximately 80. So for Br2, the mass is going to be approximately 160. So molar mass 160 by 5/3. So 3 goes up, that you can say as the equivalent mass. So this is the end of the part of valency factor topic. I hope I was able to revise all of it. That's more or less it. Let's go on to the next part of the video, which is a very small segment as compared to the previous 2 videos, where I will focus upon equivalent concept. That's all. Thank you.